Meanwhile, aboard the Cajun Queen, Pierre LeBlanc, known by his fellow anglers as Scaly Pete.
Daddy hunted sharks. I hunt sharks. It's in the blood. There was somebody better at this you'd be following down, yeah? Well, people got a lot of wrong ideas about sharks. Scientists say how we gotta coexist. Now, how you gonna coexist with that shark, huh? Shark just wanna do one thing. That's kill you, eat you, and you out. What I do, I consider a sacred honor. Kill them all if I could. Too bad, ain't but 24 hours to a day.
Shark spotted in Fatik Bayou. Several deaths reported. Shark can be identified by rusty harpoon embedded in flank.
The f*** out of my way. Got a job to do.
This is an adult bull shark. Fast, fierce, and armed quite literally to the teeth, she has little to fear here in the Gulf. The muscular marvel confidently moves through its watery world. Predator's 350 fearsome teeth are put on full display. Exhibiting behavior more common to a thresher shark, this bull makes creative use of her powerful tail. Turtle carries a criminal penalty of up to $100,000. But sharks are notoriously profligate when it comes to paying fines. The shark's unique eyes allow it to see in both bright and dim light. A shark fin is a sinister reminder to humans that the ocean remains a wild and untamed domain. An acrobatic feat worthy of an orca, cruelly imprisoned and put on display in a marine park stunt show. big fish plunges to the ocean below. Is astounding for a large marine predator. A breaching shark is a rare and calorie-intensive spectacle. The predator displays a sinuous elegance of movement. Sharks are known to make clever use of their hydronautical appendages. The mighty predator struggles for air. While it is well known that sharks feed on mollusks, fish, and seals, less discussed is their propensity to feed on feed. Maneater, accustomed to feeding on a wide variety of prey, sharks are always eager to investigate potential new food sources. Sailing vessels ruled the sea. Sharks were their constant companions.
That shark needs a good whack on their nose. Go get him, Chad.
It's our shark!
How you doing there, shark?
Such as meditation or in-home spa treatments.
Achoo. Okay, Derek, you got this, Bonner. She's sure making a lot of splashes.
Some dinner coming, boys.
Let's get her up on deck, huh?
On board the Cajun Queen, Scaly Pete looks over the catch of the day.
Yeah, this my daddy's iron, all right. But this ain't the shark. Not the one I was looking for.
How do you know?
How I know? Not big enough. This look like a mega to you. Oh, looky here. She's on for me. Hello! How you mama in there?
Whoa! But why'd you do that?
So I can identify next time I see her when I spear her.
The tiny pup responds with an instinct for survival.
You maybe want to turn off that camera.
A famous big game hunter once posited that after an animal had tasted human flesh, it forsakes its natural prey in a deadly single-minded search for the most dangerous game. Remember, when planning a cemetery, try to avoid high-risk coastal areas. Reaffirms her top predator role in the food chain. Thank you. quiet space is the ideal stage for the shark to meditate and harness her pure potentiality. Exhibiting behavior more common to whales and dolphins, this shark is able to use biosonar to locate potential prey. Time is running out for this pelagic predator. If it makes you feel better, I ate the heck out of some crockpot alligator kielbasa bites earlier. For human hunters and animal predators alike, the bayou is revered for its wildness and generosity. Thank you. of Fautic's keystone predators has led to a superabundance of catfish, which is just fine by local bully Rosie the Alligator. Water fish currently found throughout the Great Lakes region, so I have no idea what it's doing here.
Thank you.
The solitary hunter stumbles upon another source of nourishment. Alligator comes from the Spanish El Lagarto, which means the lizard, which really isn't that interesting. A peculiar biological adaptation allows the bull to survive in fresh water. Thank you. Bull shark demonstrates the importance of getting enough minerals in her diet. What remains of the shark will be fodder for worms, bacteria, and other small creatures that dine on the dead. A peculiar biological adaptation allows the bull to survive in fresh water. As a result of industrial pollution and sewage wastewater, Dead Horse Lake was designated a Superfund site in 1996. Thank you. artist spent 16 years building this sculpture out of trash pulled from the lake, only to have it thrown back in the lake by intoxicated locals. Nicknamed cooters, but I refuse to be on familiar terms with any snake-faced mullet munchers. Even for sharks, it's important to create personal time for sober self-reflection.
Thank you.
Sophisticated wildlife management has never been a priority in Port Clovis, and so amateur hour begins. When a shark dies, everything but its teeth are slowly dissolved by the briny ocean. Dead Horse Lake serves as a salient metaphor for human fallibility in the face of avoidable catastrophe. Thank you. place. Hunters ensure they'll stay in their lane, so we don't have a Planet of the Apes situation on our hands. It's impossible to predict the environmental consequences of purging our oceans of these mighty predators. Dead Horse Lake plays host to the city's working poor, who come despite its frequent water quality alerts. Barracuda is an ambush hunter, capable of speed bursts of up to 35 miles per hour.
me!
York? We got a shark here.
Who's York? I am gone.
Kind of regular there at Flamingo Joe's. You see, it's a tourist trap. But it's the only place to get a decent Cesarac that don't have me on their do not serve list.
It's sites like these that can really challenge a person's faith in endless progress and development. We appreciate the grant from Sunshine Solutions that made this show possible. We'd also like to remind viewers that mass cloning and gene editing for today's military is safer than ever. Quite a strange conglomeration of stuff will end up in the stomachs of sharks. There are 70-year-olds who survive gator attacks with nothing but a golf club. Come on. As one can see, routine micro practices of risk management haven't really been effective in cleaning up this area. attacks often occur unexpectedly and without any apparent provocation.